Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we will discuss job management window and the options available in it. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. The job management window can be accessed from two different places. Click on Configuration menu, and select Job Management option. This is the easy way to access this window. The other way is, select Home menu, and then select Control Panel. In Control Panel, under Data Category, select Job Management. We reach to the same window. Job Management window. General tab. These general settings are to set the job live check interval and to establish the priorities of individual jobs. Job live check interval in minutes allows you to specify the time interval in minutes by which active jobs are monitored. By default, the time interval is 2 minutes. Keeping less value will add load on the CommServe, so try to keep this value higher. Let's say, 5 minutes would be good enough. Job stream high watermark level is the total number of jobs that is total streams allowed in the CommServe. As you see here, it is the same value. You can increase this value if needed. Ensure you have enough storage resources, that is disk or tape devices available, that would satisfy the requirements. Also note that this is a combined value of total streams, configured for all storage policies in the CommServe. To have this set right, you need to have better understanding on data streams, device streams, and optionally, multiplexing factor. We will try to create another video covering those topics. In doubt, leave the value to default 500. One important point to note is, this setting does not affect reports. So, the maximum number of reports that can run at one time is 50. Queue jobs if other conflicting jobs are active. Use this option to start jobs in a queued state if they conflict with other running jobs. After the conflicting jobs are completed, the queued jobs resume automatically. Jobs conflict with other jobs if the operation is performed on the same CommServe object, such as a subclient, CommServe database, or storage policy. With this option disabled, the conflicting job fail, stating another job is already running for the client. Disabling this option will also affect the CommServe SLA status, so cross-check before disabling this option. This option can also be set at the client level. In the Advanced Client Properties, select Job Configuration tab. Here you see the option to enable or disable for specific client. Please note, on-demand data protection jobs are always queued because the directive and content files can change with every run. Queue jobs if activity is disabled. With this option enabled, the jobs will go into the queued state if activity control for these jobs is disabled. Once activity control for these jobs is enabled again, the queued jobs will resume automatically. This option helps to identify if backup activity of client or subclient is disabled. If yes, then you can find the valid reason for the action and decide either enable the activity or remove it from backup schedule itself. Allow running jobs to complete past the operation window. This option allows the jobs that run past the operation window rule set to run until completion. Without this option selected, the jobs will go into a pending or queued state. Queue scheduled jobs. With this option enabled, all scheduled jobs will go into the queued state. These jobs can be resumed manually, using the resume option, or by disabling this option. This option is useful during maintenance activity, where you do not want the jobs to be stopped, using disable scheduler option. Instead, have them queued in the job controller. Once the activity is completed, you can disable this option, so the queued jobs can run automatically. This option helps in keeping the SLA status of the comm cell. Do not start backups on disabled client. When selected, backups will not be performed for clients that are disabled. Sometimes, though the client is disabled, due to active backup schedule, the jobs run, and this option help prevent jobs starting for disabled or decommissioned clients. Enable multiplexing for Oracle. Normally, for Oracle backups, each stream takes one tape drive each. When this option is selected, Oracle backup streams can multiplex and write to fewer tapes, instead of requiring a tape per stream of backup. Enable multiplexing for database agents, non-Oracle, or RAC. When selected, backup streams of database agents other than Oracle or RAC can multiplex and write to fewer tapes, instead of requiring a tape per stream of backup. Enable job throttling at client level. When selected, the Enable Job Throttle checkbox on the Job Configuration tab of the Advanced Client Properties window is available. You can modify backup job performance by setting job throttling options. After you enable client-level throttling on the CommServe host, you can enable job throttling on a client and set thresholds for the number of data backup jobs that run simultaneously, and for the number of log backup jobs that run simultaneously. When the maximum number of simultaneously running jobs is reached, new backup jobs submitted for the client are queued and run when current running jobs are complete. Show individual virtual machine jobs in Job Controller. Select this option to display child jobs for VMs that are part of a hypervisor that uses indexing version 2 for VM-centric operations. By default, only parent jobs for the sub-client or backup set appear in the job controller. If you recall, in previous versions of CommVault, you see extra three additional options below, called Job Preemption Control. In version 11, those options do not appear by default. To bring the options back, you need to run the following command as is. Changing any parameter in it will lead to error, and we will show you them as well. As this is queue operation command, you need to run it from command line on the CommServe machine. Open command prompt with admin privileges. Browse to the base folder. Let's run the command by changing the SI value to 1. You need to log in order to run the command. Let's queue login from command line interface. User logged in successfully. Let's execute the command. We received error. As it says, let's type Y for yes and check. We got different error this time, and the reason is, the value is already set to Y in the CommServe DB. We need to disable or set to no in order to see the options. Let's run the command as is, with SI equal to N. Queue script executed successfully. Please note, once this command completed successfully, and settings are visible, you cannot revert it back. To see the changes, you need to close and reopen the job management window. Now you see the three options of job preemption control. Restore preempts other jobs. Normally, this option is selected by default. As it was hidden, we could not see, and now that it is brought back, and it looks the option got deselected. If you see the box selected or checked, then do not clear this option unless specifically instructed to do so. If you see it unchecked, then select this checkbox, to have restore jobs preempt other jobs. Backup preempts other backups. If you have prioritized some clients, or agents, whose backups to run before the other clients or agents, then select this checkbox, to have backup jobs preempt other jobs. With this option enabled, the other backups will get interrupted, when all the resources are busy or unavailable, when priority backups start. Backup preempts auxiliary copy. Ideally, backups are more important compared to auxiliary copy jobs. At times, as resources are locked by auxiliary copy jobs, backup jobs will be waiting for resources to complete. Select this checkbox, to have backup jobs preempt auxiliary copy jobs. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will continue discussing the other tabs and options. Please hit the like button, if you like this video, and subscribe to our channel, if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.